Hi everyone, welcome back. Hope you all are staying healthy. Today I'm going to share my mom's very special recipe, that's how to make delicious mutton dalcha, also popularly known as dal gosh, in a South Indian style with very simple steps. Do watch this video until end as I have shared useful tips. And if you like this video, please subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so, and also like and share it. So let's start. Let's learn how to make mutton dalcha at home in an easy way. First, let's see the ingredients. Here I have taken equal quantity of toor and chana dal, that's split yellow lentils and split chickpeas. That's 150 grams each. Wash and soak the dal for at least 10 to 15 minutes. Some add only chana dal or toor dal, however this combination goes great and makes the dalcha extremely delicious. Now soak the dal for few minutes. Meanwhile, we'll see what are the other ingredients we require. To add to the dal, here I have taken 3 green chilies, that's hari mirch, 1 teaspoon of cumin seeds, that's zira, 4 to 5 garlic cloves, and a half teaspoon of turmeric powder, that's haldi. Then we require 1 cup of coriander and mint leaves, that's dhania and pudina, and we're gonna make a chutney out of it, that's green masala. By just adding 2 to 3 green chilies and with a little salt, just grind them together and a green chutney is ready. Moving on, we require mutton pieces. Here I have taken 1 kg mutton with bone, which I have cleaned and washed with little turmeric and salt. Then we require 4 medium sized sliced onions. This onion we'll use for cooking dal and also for preparing the masalas, which we will see further. Then we require 4 medium sized tomato slices. Even this we'll use for cooking the dal and preparing the masala. Then I have taken 1 bottle gourd, that's lauki, 1 medium size which I have cut in big size, you may cut as per your preference, and soak it in water. Then we require 4 medium sized potatoes. Even this I have cut into half and soaked in water. Let's move on and see the spices that we require. So here I have taken 2 tablespoons of ginger garlic, that's adrak lasun ka paste, 2 tablespoons of red chili, that's lal mirch powder, half a teaspoon of turmeric, that's haldi powder, 3 to 4 dry red chilies that we'll use for tempering, 1 teaspoon of garam masala powder, 3 tablespoons of coriander, that's dhania powder, 1 tablespoon of cumin, that's zira powder, and half a teaspoon of black pepper, that's kali mirch powder. Spices you may take as per your taste. Then here I have taken 1 green unripe mango, that's also known as kairi. Then soak 1 small lemon sized tamarind. If you don't have green mango, then you may double the quantity of tamarind. Since I am using the green mango, I am taking little tamarind. Soak it in a water and we'll be extracting the pulp out of it. Then we require ghee, that's clarified butter, and oil. Take it in equal quantity, that's 2 tablespoons each. And then salt as per taste. Now let's cook dalcha. Firstly, we need to cook the dal in the mutton. For that, into a pressure cooker, add the soaked dal and the spices. After adding the spices, add the mutton and then add salt. Add salt as per your taste. Here I have added 2 teaspoons. Then goes in little onion and little tomatoes. That's around 1 medium size sliced each. And the remaining we'll be using for preparing the masalas. Add sufficient water and then mix it well. Once they are well combined, cover and pressure cook until dals are well cooked and mutton must be 75% done. Depending on your pressure cooker, cook the dal and mutton. For me, it took 3 whistles. Once the dal and mutton are cooked and pressure releases and cools down completely, let's check. As you can see, the dals are well cooked and so are the mutton. Now let's check the mutton. It's 75% done. It's perfect. Now separate the mutton pieces from the dal and we'll cook this mutton along with the masalas. You may also cook the dals and mutton separately. However, I prefer this way as the mutton stew gets combined with dal and it enhances its taste more. You can see the muttons are separated now. Now to the dal, add the tamarind pulp water and mix it well. Now let's move on in preparing the masala. For that, into a heavy bottom pan, add oil and ghee and allow it to heat it up. Keep the flame on medium. Then add the remaining sliced onions and fry it until it turns golden in color. Saute it well. Add little salt and mix well, as this will speed up the cooking process. You can see the onions are fried well now. Now to this, add ginger garlic paste and saute it until raw aroma goes away. It's sauteed well now. Now add the green masala which we have prepared. Mix and saute for 1 to 2 minutes. The flavor coming from the coriander, mint and green chilies. Trust me, it's super awesome. Now the green masala is well roasted. Now to this, add the spices, that's turmeric powder, red chili powder, black pepper powder, cumin powder, garam masala and coriander powder. Mix all well and fry the masala for 1 to 2 minutes. Keep stirring continuously, otherwise it will stick to the bottom. Once the masalas are well roasted, as you can see, it's time to add the tomatoes. Add the tomatoes, mix and saute well and cook it until it's completely turns soft. Soon you'll see the tomatoes are cooked very well and the traces of oil started coming out. So at this stage, we're gonna add the potatoes and bottle guard, that's locky to it. So add in the potatoes and the locky, that's the bottle guard. The combination of the meat along with the lentils, locky and other veggies along with the spices makes this dish very very tasty. Now mix these veggies along with the spices and roast for a minute. Once it's well roasted, add in the mutton and then roast it for another 2 to 3 minutes. Once the veggies and the muttons are well roasted, as you can see, then add the water, say around 1 cup, and then mix it well. Cover and cook until the veggies and muttons are well cooked. As mutton is already 75% done, the remaining 25% will cook now. Cover and cook it and keep the flame on medium low. You can see the veggies and the muttons are cooked. Now let me show you. The potato is done. Let's check the bottle guard, that's locky. Even the locky is done. And now let's check the mutton. Even the mutton has turned tender and it's very well done. Once the veggies and the mutton are cooked, as you have seen, at this stage add the cooked dal and mix it well. And now to this, add little water and adjust the consistency as you prefer. For more thickness, add little water, and for thin consistency, add little more water. And also check the seasoning and add salt if required. This is the consistency I prefer. Now to this, add the green mangoes. The reason we are adding it at the end is that it just takes very less time to cook. Just in 1 to 2 minutes it cooks. So always add it at the last and mix it well. Now allow the dalcha gravy to simmer for 2 to 3 minutes on a low flame. It's been simmering for a few minutes and you can see the gravy is almost done. And also the green mangoes which I have added is cooked now. Now let's prepare the final tadka, that's the tempering, which will make it even more delicious and flavorful. For that, into a pan add 2 tablespoons of desi ghee or clarified butter and then add 1 sliced onions. Fry the onion until it turns golden brown in color. Add little salt, just say a pinch of it, and then soon you will see the onions are fried well. So at this stage, reduce the flame to very low and then add dry red chilies around 3 to 4 as per your spice taste. And now switch off the flame and then goes in the final ingredient, that's the mutton masala, around 1 teaspoon. If you don't have mutton masala, you may just add a pinch of garam masala. This last step will enhance the taste and flavor of dalcha. As the tadka or the tempering is ready, just add this to a simmering gravy. And that's it. An extremely flavorful, super awesome, lip-smacking dalcha or dal gosh is absolutely ready. Look at it, how beautiful it looks. And it tastes super awesome. Finally, garnish it with chopped coriander leaves and mix it well. An irresistible, flavorfully awesome mutton dalcha is ready. Serve it with ghee rice or bhagara chawal, or also you may have it with roti, naan or paratha. Hope you like this recipe. If so, please subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so. Also like and share it. Do try this super delicious, awesome dalcha at home and leave your comments below. We personally love to have this dalcha with ghee rice, that's bhagara chawal. Ghee rice recipe coming soon, so do stay connected. Soon we'll be coming up with another interesting recipe. Until then, take care of yourself and stay healthy and safe. Thanks for watching. Happy cooking. Bye-bye.